Good morning, I'm Trish Pahotnick, and this is Cynopsis, your first early morning briefing. Today is Tuesday, the 24th of August, 2010. Here are today's top stories. Cooking Channel announced a menu of new original shows joining its lineup this fall. Rachel Ray's Week in a Day. Rachel Ray teaches viewers how to create a full week's worth of meals from scratch in one day. This premieres September 25th at 3 p.m. Bitchin' Kitchen. Based on the hit web series, this series features chef-slash-comedian Nadia G as she serves up tasty dishes such as one-night-stand breakfast to dump-em desserts, all the while wearing 3-inch stilettos. This opens October 7th at 10 p.m. Brunch at Bobby's. Chef Bobby Flay serves up his favorite Sunday morning menus from a kitchen in the Hamptons. This premieres on the 16th of October at 2 p.m. For a full listing of all the new programs on the Cooking Channel, please visit Cynopsis.com. Create TV also adds a new cooking show in September, Rachel's Favorite Food at Home, featuring Irish culinary expert Rachel Allen. Now be sure to check local listings for airtime of Rachel's Favorite Food at Home. TLC examines people who have a strange obsession surrounding a particular food in the new series Freaky Eaters. This opens September 5th at 10 p.m. And ABC is petitioning the Second Circuit Court of Appeals to disregard the FCC's $1.4 million penalty against 52 ABC affiliates over a 2003 broadcast of NYPD Blue per BNC. ABC says the court's recent decision involving Fox television stations was now binding law and therefore signals ABC's fines should not be enforced. BET's reality show The Michael Vick Project is reportedly not heading for a second season as the NFL quarterback Michael Vick decided to not continue doing the show, reports ProFootballTalk.com. And History's series premiere of Swamp People, on Sunday at 10 p.m., had 4.2 million total viewers and became the network's best original series premiere ever among all key demos. Sunday night also ushered in the fifth season opener of Keeping Up with the Kardashians on E! At 10 p.m., which delivered the series' highest-rated and most-watched premiere ever as well. The series' debut netted 4.7 million total viewers, and following at 10:30, E! Launched the series' The Spin Crowd with an average of more than 2.3 million total viewers. And also on Sunday at 10 p.m., Lifetime aired the season 4 finale of Army Wives, delivering the drama's most-watched episode of the year across multiple demos with 3.9 million total viewers. Tennis Channel offers up a second year of round-the-clock U.S. Open coverage beginning next Monday, consisting of 73 hours of live matches and a total of 234 hours of U.S. Open telecasts over the two-week competition. Tennis champ Tracy Austin also joins the team of lead analysts that includes Jimmy Connors, Martina Navratilova, and host of U.S. Open Tonight Breakfast at the Open, Lindsay Davenport. And last up today, one of Sci-Fi's new shows has added Andrea Martin as a regular per the live feed. 3 Inches is about a boy who can move objects 3 inches using his mind. Martin will play the boy's overprotective mother. And that's a wrap for this Tuesday. Be sure to check your email for the full printed version of today's synopsis with new executive moves and more on ratings, side ads, a few other bits and pieces that did not make it into this podcast, and remember to check out tonight's primetime broadcast lineup. This is a Cynopsis Media production in association with 311 West. For Cynthia Turner, who wrote and compiled Cynopsis, in Connecticut, I'm Trish Pahonik.
I'm going to have a good day. Even if I make it myself, I'm going to have a good day. I don't need no one else. I'm gonna have a good day. Nothing wrong I could do. I'm gonna have a good day. Hope you have a good day too.